Thank you. Good evening and welcome. It's not on yet, is it? Let's see if we can. I'd like to welcome you all. I'm Frank Harrell, chorus member, 1967, 68, and 68, 69. I'd like to thank you to the Green Hills congregation for hosting the Lipscomb Academy Chorus and the choral alumni today. Walt Lieber asked me to make a couple of comments regarding the history of the chorus, probably because yesterday when we got together, Bill Staggs and I were the two from the 60s. There was no one from the 50s, but Marianelle Chumley was from the 40s. Bill's going to say a little more about that. My history is that, by the way, my mother was campus nurse, so I started in the fifth grade on campus. My history can be summed up by saying it was, without question, one of the most fun memories, the fondest memories that I have of high school. I think everyone here in this room either had a similar experience or has somehow become what Valley and I call ourselves, which is chorus junkies. We still follow the chorus around. Of course, we have a couple of extra reasons to want to do that. There's a long history of the chorus, and it begins. Bill's going to talk about some of that, but we've had several directors over the years, leading ultimately, and I do mean ultimately, to Robert King, who has now been the director of the high school chorus for 40 years. Let's give him one more hand if you hadn't had a chance to do that. And leading up of late to the inclusion of Elizabeth Patterson, my daughter. So it is continuing to be one of my greatest memories. In keeping with the tradition of the short devotional before the chorus performs, and that's what Walt really wanted us to sort of recreate tonight. Tonight I'll begin reading with a reading, and then alumnus Andrew Youngblood, I think 2014 is what he told me, will lead us in a song. By the way, Andrew was the primary speaker for those devotionals for about 3 years before, and so I got to hear him speak a lot and really enjoyed the job he did. That's where I stop and tell you that my senior year, of course, Walt Lieber was the weekly speaker, and I got to hear the same sermon week after week from Martin. He used a really cheesy story I'm not going to tell. Got a little old. But proud to say that I had that experience going all the way back with Walt, one of our great gospel preachers. And at this point, I'd like to remember a couple of things, and that is the person who lined up, at least my junior and senior year, I think, the what we called the homiletics club, lined up the speaker for the pre-chorus addresses, was Hubert Lawing. One of my favorite people. Great guy. So I'll be reading, and then Andrew Youngblood will be leading us in a song. Then fellow choral alumnus from the 60s, Bill Staggs, will read another scripture and have a few comments. Holden Montgomery from 2017 will lead us in another hymn. I'm going to come back up after that and lead us in a closing prayer, and we will then be ready for the chorus to sing. Thank you to all who planned and hosted this weekend, especially Sharon Davidson, and those who have come tonight. So let's begin. I'm going to read something we're all extremely familiar with, the 100th Psalm. Make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It's he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people. We're the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations.
Look in the pockets that are affixed to the bottom of the seat cushions for the pew. You will find songbooks in there. And if you'll turn those songbooks to number 949, I will enter his gates. Number 949, I will enter his gates. 949. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice.
Good evening. My name is Bill Staggs, and I sang in the chorus in 1966. Harold Litford was my choral director, and I know that y'all have already heard that Marinelle was in the very first chorus that was in the high school, and we have discussed that, and I hadn't asked her. It's either 66 or 48 or 46. So. Her choral director was Gabriel. That's the reason that she is so sweet today. I'm going to read 2 Timothy 1:12. That is why I am suffering as I am, yet this is no cause for shame, because I know whom I have believed, and am convinced that he is able to guard what I have entrusted to him until that day.
When I pulled the hymnal out of the bottom of the seat, it had dust on it. So dust off your hymnals again and turn with me to 291. 291, I know not why God's wondrous grace, and if you would please be standing with me as well. We'll sing verses 1, 2, and 4. I know not why God's wondrous grace to me he hath made known, nor why unworthy Christ in love redeemed before his own. But I know that he is able to keep that
Pray with me, please. Our great and glorious God in heaven, creator of all that we see, we thank you for the beauty of this world. We, Father, can only imagine the beauty of heaven. We love and we enjoy singing, bringing praises to you. We can only imagine what it will be like in heaven to hear the angels sing. But Father, we think this is close. We hope, Father, that our sacrifice of praise to you is good for you to hear. Thank you, Father, for all that you've done for us, for all you've given us, for this ability to sing and to praise you. We thank you for your Son, and we pray through him. Amen.
It's a real pleasure for us to be with you here at Green Hills. And again, thank you for hosting us. And there's a few extra people here tonight. And so we're particularly been looking forward to this night. We'll begin. There are programs distributed. I hope that you have access to those. You can follow along. We want to introduce every song. There are translations in there. The foreign language works as well. But we will have our current high school chorus. And then a few more high school singers will join us here in just a few minutes.
Thank you. Thank you. years, some mistake has been made. It can't be 40 years. Start with it. But in the list of thanks would have to be the Lipscomb for letting me play for a living. I've never wanted a real job, and this has worked out really well. There has been, I don't know if it's idle or random speculation, but there is no exit strategy, so that's not what this is about. And the other group to thank is the students who endured me, who would hear about me and come to the room anyway. That said something about them and those who came before. I really want to thank Tim Dishman, who's come to be with us, who I need to thank the most because he left. He's gave me an opportunity to come to Lipscomb. And so he's going to be conducting one of our pieces in a moment, but it's been a lot to have him with us. And so now I think they're up. Are they up there? They make it okay. Solid. Now we're going to sing a few songs with the alums along with us. And I'll say a word about this piece. It's the most sold choral octave, choral piece. And it's, you may wonder why. No choral piece sells a whole lot of copies. I mean, it's just not. It's not a big profit industry. But it's the words to this resonate with choral singers. And so I'm told by the composer, who's a friend of mine, that it's the most often stolen piece that choristers keep, don't want to turn it back in. And so as you hear the words, think about the message it has about singing. Sing me to heaven.
Words of honor, faith, and thanks, and my all. been a real blessing to be a part of the weekend. Wonderful folks to be with, representing 76 years of just people that have been in chorus, even though the chorus existed before then. But I was very pleased to see the members of the 80 to 84 groups that I was a part of, and also to see some folks here that meant a lot to me in that time. Nelson Eddy, Richard Jones, just to name a couple, and I may have missed a few, but it's wonderful to see them as well. I wanted to let the alumni chorus members know that I was the most influential chorus director in all the years of this event. High school courses because I left in 84 and so he has done wonderful things with the program. I've been able to follow some things over the years from a distance, and I'm just real pleased to know that it's in great hands and has been for this long. Thank you very much.
Sorry. Did I mention there are CDs and tapes to take home? Have a great night. Thank you.